This is electromagnetism. Practice knowledge assessment, T1 to T2. The T's represent the topic points from the training package. And it's Dr. Ken here with you today. So how do the videos work? Well, there's five distinct steps. One, I pose a question or a problem. Then you must pause the video and try to solve the problem. That's the second step. Third step is when you come off pause, again, I will give you a hint, and again, you pause to continue the solution if you've not already been able to do so. Four, I provide an answer that's explained. This is the power of this particular revision system and practice assessments, is that not only do we get you to practice the questions, we explain how we got to the answers. And then step five, play the video again and proceed to the next question. So let's get on with the first question. What are the contacts of a reed switch made from? A, diamagnetic material. B, ferromagnetic material. C, paramagnetic material. Or D, non-magnetic material. So pause here. Here's your hint. A reed switch closes in the presence of a magnetic field. So what kind of material would cause a reed switch to close in the presence of a magnetic field? And here's your answer. It has to be a ferromagnetic material. So non-magnetic material obviously wouldn't work. Diamagnetic material only becomes magnetized when magnetic fields around, and a paramagnetic material only stays partially magnetized after you've introduced a magnetic field. So the answer was B in this particular case. The contacts for a reed switch are made from a ferromagnetic material. Two, which of the following devices typically uses a permanent magnet? A, an audio speaker. C, a contactor. C, a ballast, that's a choke or a coil that's used in fluorescent lighting. Or D, a circuit breaker. So which of the following devices typically uses a permanent magnet? So pause here. Here's your hint. Think about how each device works and eliminate the ones if you don't already know exactly which one it is. So the answer is A, an audio speaker. An audio speaker has a fixed magnet, and it has a coil, an electromagnet, that operates from an electrical signal, which converts that electrical signal back into mechanical energy, airwaves, that operates the speaker. Contactor has an electromagnet in it. A ballast is a restrictive or AC resistive device used to control the current in lighting. And a circuit breaker has a magnetic trip, but it's an electromagnet. So they're all electromagnets of some kind except for A, which has a permanent magnet. Question three, which of the following materials is ferromagnetic? So pause here. Here's the hint. Think about each material type and its properties. So think about each material type and particularly its magnetic properties. So the only one here which is ferromagnetic is nickel. Gold is non-magnetic, brass is non-magnetic, and tantalum is a metal, again has no magnetic properties. Nickel has some magnetic properties. Four, which of the following materials would provide an effective magnetic screen? So you're wanting to screen something from a magnetic field. Which one would work best here? A, copper. B, brass. C, iron. D, lithium. Here's the hint. What material is common and will conduct a magnetic circuit? So if you're going to use something as a screen, it's got to be reasonably common, easy to get access up to, and will conduct a magnetic circuit. So the answer is iron. Copper will conduct an electrical current, but not a magnetic circuit. The same with brass. Iron will conduct both an electrical current and a magnetic field. And lithium, as a metal, will not conduct any magnetic fields, but it will conduct an electrical field. 5. Which type of fixed magnet is pictured here? What kind of fixed magnet? A. A bar magnet. B. A bent bar magnet. C. A horseshoe magnet. D. A toroid magnet. So pause here. So here's your hint. The shape should help. What shape is this in the shape of? So of course this was a horseshoe magnet. It is a form of bar magnet, and it's certainly a bent bar magnet, but we would call it a horseshoe magnet. A toroid magnet is a magnet that is this donut shape. It's circular with a hole through the middle. That's a toroid magnet. 6. If two parallel conductors are carrying a current, the magnetic forces acting between the conductors is what? To the distance between them. So what's the question mark is, what's missing? If the two parallel conductors are carrying a current, the magnetic forces acting between the conductors is something to the distance between them. A, the product of the two currents times. B, directly proportional. C, zero. Or D, inversely proportional. So pausing here. Here's your hint. What happens to magnetic fields over a distance irrespective of attraction or repulsion? What happens to the forces as you move the conductors further and further apart? So the answer was they're inversely proportional. The further you move them apart, the longer the distance is apart, the strength of the magnetic field reduces by the square, or inversely proportional. 7. If two parallel conductors are carrying a current in the same direction, the magnetic field will do what? A, will rotate to 90 degrees apart. Will be attracted to each other. C, will be forced apart. Or D, will oscillate. So pause here. Here's your hint. Draw a diagram that includes how the magnetic fields interact with each other. So they will be attracted to each other. So we did a little diagram, and we have a conductor with current traveling towards us, and another one with current traveling towards us. We're going to get magnetic fields around these in the same directions. So if those are the directions, this will be the direction as well. And eventually those magnetic fields will all want to combine, and they will all be in the same direction. And that will have the effect of wanting to pull them towards each other. So we'll kind of get this effect. Which of the following devices incorporates an electromagnet from our little list here? A, a contactor, B, a compass, C, a condenser microphone, or D, a push button? So which of these devices incorporates an electromagnet? Here's the hint. Draw a diagram. It shows how each is constructed. And our answer is a contactor. A contactor is a coil with an electromagnet. So we normally have an electromagnet of some kind with coils around it and that electromagnet is connected to a series of contacts. I'll just draw three of them. It's connected to the plunger, and when you energize the coil, it will close the contacts. When you de-energize, it will open the contacts. A compass uses a fixed magnet. A condenser microphone uses a fixed magnet, and a push button doesn't have any magnets in it whatsoever. Question 9. A coil produces a magnetic force of 1,000 amp turns when 25 milliamps passes through the coil. Calculate the number of turns. So a bit of a calculation here for you. So pause here. So here's the hint. The formula is in the units, it's in amp turns, and you know how many amps there are. Can you use the amp turns to work out the number of turns? So here's the answer. The amps turns equals the current multiplied by the turns, which is what amp turns means. So we have 1,000 equals 25 times 10 to the minus 3. That's your 25 milliamps multiplied by the number of turns. You've simply got to transpose the equation. So that's all we're doing here. We're now just transposing the equation. We're saying the number of turns has got to be 1,000 divided by 25 times 10 to the minus 3, and that gives us 40,000 turns. So it's 40,000 turns. Nice and easy to calculate. The trick there being remember that quite often the units are the formula, which they were here. Units were the formula. 10. The flight of an arrow is a convention to indicate current in a conductor. If a dot is used in the cross section of a conductor, what does this indicate? A. Negative current is flowing. B, current is flowing away from the observer. C, positive current is flowing. Or D, current is flowing towards the observer. So pause here. So here's the hint. The arrow is an analogy for current. So if you think about it, what does it mean if we can see the dot of the arrow? The answer is the current is flowing towards the observer. It's as though the arrow is coming straight at you, and all you can see is the very point of the arrow. If you could see across, it would mean you'd see the flights of the arrow, and the current is traveling away from you. But in this case, the current is traveling towards you. So that brings us to the end of our first practice assessment for T1 through to T2. Thanks for listening. Hope you've learned a little bit more about electromagnetism.